In this video, we're given a mass on an inclined plane, and that plane is inclined with an angle of theta. And we're asked to decompose the weight vector for the object into parallel and perpendicular components to the surface, and then find the magnitude of the normal force. Finally, we get a concept question about how the magnitude of the normal force compares to the weight vector. So we'll start things out by putting in the weight vector, and the force of gravity is always straight down and has a magnitude of mg. To decompose this into perpendicular and parallel components, we've got to find this angle right here. So if you haven't seen it before, I'll hash out the trig real quick for how we prove it. And what we do is draw a right triangle right here. And then we say, well, the sum of the angles in a triangle is 180 degrees. So theta must add with this angle to give us 90 degrees. In other words, this angle is 90 minus theta. Next, we examine this right angle. And that right angle involves the angle that we're after. And I can say 90 minus theta plus this unknown angle question mark has to be equal to 90 degrees. You then subtract 90 from both sides, add theta to both sides, and we discover that theta is exactly the same as that unknown angle we were looking for. So from now on, when you see an inclined plane problem, you're probably going to need to decompose the weight vector into parallel and perpendicular components. And you know that the angle between the weight and the perpendicular is given by theta, the same as the angle of incline for the ramp. Now that we've figured that out, we can quickly write down the magnitude of the adjacent side of this right triangle. That's going to be our perpendicular piece. And that's mg cosine theta. Again, the adjacent side is given by the hypotenuse times the cosine of the angle. And then the magnitude of the opposite side is given by mg sine theta. But normally we go straight to drawing that opposite side attached to the mass itself. It's more useful to show it there. And that's the component of the force of gravity pointing down the ramp, parallel to the surface. So besides the weight, there's one other force acting on this object, and it's the normal force. And that's the force acting perpendicular to any surface in order to stop an object from sinking into the surface. So this mass is constrained to the surface, and I know that I have no acceleration perpendicular to the surface. The mass is not going to spontaneously jump off of it or sink into it. Therefore, the forces must be balanced in the perpendicular direction. And this means the normal force must have a magnitude of mg cosine theta. Finally, we're asked this concept question, how does the magnitude of the normal force compare to the weight? And I can see back when I was doing my decomposition that the perpendicular component of the force of gravity is just one of the legs of a right triangle where the weight is the hypotenuse. And the hypotenuse is always longer than either one of the legs. So the weight is bigger than mg cosine theta, which means it's bigger than the normal force. If you find the physics content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce over 100 new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.